consider supporting Eat My Grits ASMR on Patreon for just $1 a month. Link below in the description.
Yo, what's up? Grit Squad, it's your boy, Cedric. And my day is crazy. I got off work because I had to do inventory. Inventory where you count all the stuff to see what your sales and customers and all that stuff. And I'm tired. It's a manager's position job, even though I'm not a manager, but I'm training to be a manager. So yeah. Because your boy is good. Work hard, whatever job. So I ain't even been there too. I've been there since December, and they already want me to be a manager for them. But anyway, also, my girlfriend mad at me. I don't know if we're still together or not right now. But I texted her on the 22nd. She never texts back, maybe, and she said her phone didn't get it. So yeah, she posted something on Snapchat. And I was like, what's going on here? So yeah. You know, I got doing a great squad. Hoodie. It's comfortable, man. I'll get one. Link in the description. Okay. But today's story, I didn't want to tell because I've always been embarrassed about it. But now that I have kids and one day I'm going to have to talk to them about it. And I just want people to be very informed. I got the green screen back here, and only had one studio light because my cousin broke the other one, so I'm not sure if it's gonna turn out right. But with you guys' Patreon donations, I bought some more studio lights to try to get the lighting better in here. Okay, so and like thank you guys again for donations to help fix the PC so that I can put out these quality videos. Thanks to you guys. So, yeah, I didn't want to tell this story, but I'm going to tell the story of how I caught gonorrhea. Okay. So, I lost my virginity at 13. Okay. And, I didn't use rubbers back then. I didn't really know. I grew up in a very over sexual environment. Like all my brother, like not my little brother, but my oldest brother, he was a drug dealer. Cousins, they were all drug dealers. And my mom, she was very heavy into the casino when I was little, so she would always leave us with them and go to the casino, and the drug dealers are watching us. So we saw a lot that we shouldn't have seen at our age. So yeah. But lost my virginity at 13. I don't think I did any, well, like, it was months in between. I was still doing stuff, but it was just with the same two girls who lived, like, across the street from us. All the way up until I was 16. I don't know if I did anything with them after that age. But when I was 15, I started talking to a girl, and I broke her virginity. We broke up when I turned 16 because she cheated on me. That's a story for another day. Alright, so now I'm 16, okay, and I'm broken up with this other girl for a good little minute. It was my little cousin's birthday party. I don't remember the year, but I was 16. I don't feel like counting back. But we were at my little cousin's birthday party, and you know, we're having a good time. And I just so happened to walk from the backyard to the front. I see this little skinny chick walking down the street. And she had these, I remember she had these big, pretty eyes. Like, that's what I remember about her. And they just stuck out to me. So I yelled something. I'm not sure what I did, but she was on the phone. I probably was like, hey, when you gonna put my number in that phone? Y'all try that. I don't know if it'll work these days. But I was like, hey, when you gonna put my number in your phone? She had a little, it was a T-Mobile Nokia red flip phone, I remember. And so I walked up to her. I didn't have a cell phone just then. I walked up to her and put my number in the phone. It's my house number. Hold on, y'all. That was my house just give me a call the next day, because I knew, like, I wasn't gonna be at home for the rest of that day. And so the next day come, what happened was I just got a touchscreen phone. So now this was like, this had to be 2000. Probably 2007, around 2008, something like up in there. Yeah, something like that. So I had a touchscreen phone, and like, it was something very new around that time. It was just an AT&T touchscreen. And she called the house phone, and I gave her my cell phone number to hit me back up on this number and whatnot, and we talked for a good little while. Now me, I don't do friendship with girls. I don't care about your feelings and none of that. I'm sorry, I just don't do friendship with girls. If we're not having sex, I don't wanna be anything with you. That's how I am. Don't care about like your feelings and stuff and who hurt you. Like, I really don't care. I'm sorry. Sounds mean, but that's who I am. I'm a nice guy, but I don't care. I just don't wanna be friends with girls. Like, I don't do it. So if we're not, you know, talking about this, I don't care. And usually, I give girls about 2 weeks, and if I really like them, a month before we try to engage in that. Otherwise, I'm moving on. I don't have time. Life's too short. I'm sorry. But anyway, so we were talking for a good while. Then we end up, you know, doing stuff. We use protection all the time, okay? And one day she comes over. And the condom was in my bedroom, like it was in my dresser. And I don't know why, but this day we just didn't use it. Because now after this, we've been talking for months. And I just was like, let's not use it. And mind you, she was the only sex partner I had, but we were never boyfriend and girlfriend. We never said that. We never, like, were accomplishing that. So if she was with somebody else, I couldn't be mad, and I wouldn't be mad, because I never said she was my girlfriend. I just never did it. But anyway, we had sex throughout this time, months. And this day, I saw that right before she came over, I was looking at the condoms in the dresser, but I closed it, and I never pulled them out. And she came over, and we had sex, and I thought nothing of it, and we didn't use the condom, thought nothing of it. Went through my day doing regular things, video games, watching TV and all that stuff. And the next day I wake up and I go to the bathroom, and it is on fire. I'm pissing and it's leaking white stuff. Like, when I woke up, it was leaking, but I'm like, pre-cum, like, and I've had that before, not thinking about it. And I probably like thought I had a wet dream or something, but I don't know. I was 16, young, still going through puberty and stuff. So went to the bathroom, it's on fire, it's leaking, and I scream, I say, Mama, I scream. My mom, like, boy, what's going on? And I tell her what's going on, and she's like, oh boy, you gotta go downtown to the clinic. Now, the clinic was closed at this time. It was too late. So we had sex on a Thursday. It was a Friday that I discovered that I had it, because I remember my mom saying, well, the clinic's closed, we're gonna have to wait till Monday. Mind you, I went through 2 days of leaking out of my hole, peeing and it burning, and I felt very embarrassed. I felt humiliated and all this. I didn't talk to the girl. I didn't tell her anything. I just didn't talk to her. So everybody, like my brothers and my sister, my older brother, older sister, were telling me, we've been through it, dude. I didn't feel so bad. It was like, we've been through it, and all that. And I'm thinking I got something really bad. I mean, any STD is really bad. You don't want any of them. But anyway, so Saturday and Sunday, I'm going through this 2 days. I'm like, not feeling it. I don't want to talk to nobody. I'm just like, I didn't fart. That was my chair. I'm like, huh. So Monday comes. It's my first time going down, and my mom's with me. We wait, get my ticket, my little number thing. Wait, they call my number. Going to the office, my mom. You're not supposed to have anybody in there but my mom. I was 16, I was minor, so my mom can't come in there. I was in there doing my paperwork and all that stuff, and the lady was making fun of me, yo. So I'm telling her and everything, telling her what I feel, what it feels like, and writing my information, address, and all this stuff. And the lady had this little red bear. And she says, her and my mom were joking about it. And she pressed the button on the bear, and the thing starts singing this song. You feeling hot, hot, hot. Some. You know the little song. You feeling hot, hot, hot. And I'm just so embarrassed. I'm like, this lady's janking me, roasting me right now. It's crazy. Anyway, so finish the paperwork, go sit down, get called in to the thing to see what you got. And well, really, they, you know, with my case, they can tell what I had because I was leaking, okay? Like, it was white stuff, just like whitish, yellowish, leaking from my penis. So she told me what I had, and it was kind of real. So I'm leaking. She gets a Q-tip and swabs it, and she sticks it in your B-hole. Very uncomfortable. So I'm trying to let y'all know, if you're going to have sex, use protection. You do not want this happening to you. So she swabs it and puts it in a little bag for the sample to send off to the lab. And what else was I going to say? And she tells me you have gonorrhea because she can tell just by looking at it because I'm leaking so bad. So she gives me these big pills, like this freaking big, I have to take. And she pulls out a needle and she's like, pull down your pants. I'm thinking she's about to stick my dick, but she sticks me in the ass, and like, that was like, I'm not afraid of needles. I'm not scared of getting shots. I've been getting needles. I've donated blood. I don't, it doesn't bother me. She sticks the needle in my ass, and I jump hard as hell. Like, I hated the needle. Anyway, they did that, drew blood, and sent it off to the lab and everything. So I text the girl, and I tell her, look, you gave me gonorrhea. I was not with any other female but you. These past months, I was with nobody else. And what I learned is females don't really know that they have anything until they give it to a male, like, because of the whole situation. Like, they don't really know until, yeah. So I text her, I told her, go get checked and all that stuff. And she's up there like, no, you got it from some other girl, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, no, I got it from you. Go get checked. And a lot of my cousins were like, need to beat her ass. I'm like, no, I'm not finna beat her up because she gave me an STD. I should have been smart and used a condom. But anyway, so yeah, she gave me a gonorrhea. And, you know, you get your test back and all that stuff. The lady like, yeah, you got gonorrhea. And after 2 weeks, the lady was, get your test back. Well, she knew that day, but after 2 weeks, you get your test back because they check for HIV, AIDS, and all that stuff. See, you're good on everything. You're not positive for HIV or AIDS, anything. You just tested positive for the gonorrhea. And they gave me everything. They gave me some big white pills, nasty pills that you had to take for like almost 2 weeks or some 7 days, 2 weeks. And yeah, but the girl, I told her to get tested and all that because, you know, she needs to. She gave me gonorrhea. And after that, you know, I just was very, very careful with how I approach sex. You know, I always get tested with your partner if you're gonna have sex with them and all that stuff, like, make sure you get tested, okay? And basically, that's the story of how I caught an STD, which was gonorrhea. Make sure you guys wrap it up if you are going to have sex. It is real. There was a chart in there, too, about the state of Alabama. It was like blue dots for little bitty, like, gonorrhea and stuff like that. And it wasn't that many. And I live in Mobile, Alabama. And it had red dots on there. Through the whole state of Alabama, it had the most red dots in the area for HIV and AIDS in Mobile, Alabama. So I became very cautious of how I deal with women. I make sure we get tested together. I am not trying to go through that ever again. Worst feeling ever. Shots, worse medicines, worse this. Don't listen, just wrap it up. The best way to not to avoid all this is to just wait to marriage, or, you know, be celibate. I'm sorry, I can't give y'all the advice, because I'm never gonna do that. But anyway, that was the story, you guys. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe if you're new. Share this for awareness too. Peace.